as I give the introduction to this all-important topic of how to discipline our children. So I believe that even our children should listen carefully, because this is something that I hope your parents will agree with the Word of God, and including you, so that you will see how you are supposed to behave as children in your family. So you see that the devil wanted to destroy our homes. And what better way that the devil can destroy our home if he can destroy our children? Because we are going to pass or fade away from the sin, but our children will be the one to continue the legacy, as we call it, as they grow older. So we have to be sure that they will grow in grace and in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ, and that they will be trained in a way so that even when they will get to adulthood, they're not going to leave the principles of the Word of God. But first, let us look at some verses so that we will know how important our study is going to be. Let us look at Isaiah chapter 55, verse number 11. You see, our final authority, as I have prayed a while ago, is the Word of God. And the Word of God is very important in our lives, especially as a Christian. Without the Word of God, then there is no way that we will know God's will, and there is no way that we will know what to do in our Christian life. The Bible says, "So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I send it." So we can see that the Word of God always has a purpose. It wanted to accomplish something. And when the Word of God wanted to accomplish something, we can see that it is for the prosperity. I'm not talking about wealth, but for the spiritual prosperity wherein the Word of God was sent, or to whom the Word of God was sent. So when God utter his word towards you or me, that word has a purpose. And the design of that word, if obeyed, will result in our spiritual progress and spiritual prosperity. No matter what we do with the Word of God, accept it or reject it, it will accomplish its purpose. So if you reject it, it will accomplish the purpose of knowing that if you're not going to make the Word of God as your final authority, then you're going to have a life, a chaotic life. You will make a mess of your life. So this is the Word of God. So why does it has a purpose, and why can it accomplish something in the lives of the people? Because according to Hebrews chapter 4 and verse number 12, the Word of God is alive. These are not just words, but these are living words. These are not just words consist of letters, but they are spirit and they are life. For the Word of God is quick, it means alive, and powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Meaning to say, the Word of God will make it clear to us about our intentions. It will make it clear to us about our motives. Sometimes we can fool people, but we cannot fool God, because His Word will see to it that we know the reason why we are doing these things in our lives. So it is alive. It can do something. That's why it can change, because it is powerful. No other book have changed the lives of so many people compared to the Word of God. Real change. Change that lasts. Change that linger or that stays forever. And then in Joshua 1:8, we know this, that as I have said, the purpose is to provide or to give success. So meaning to say, if the Word of God is given, and if we are going to meditate upon the Word of God, if we are going to obey the Word of God, then it will give us success. Meaning to say, there is no way, listen, that we will fail if we are going to make the Word of God as the guide of our lives. Why? Because whatever question or confusion or doubts we may have in our minds regarding this life, the Word of God provides the answer. Look at John chapter 5, verse 39. John 5, 39. Search the scriptures, for in them ye think ye have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me. So we can see that by searching the scripture, we can find the answer to all the questions of life, and the answer is always the Lord Jesus Christ. We can find the answer. If you want to find the answer regarding what is a true, a good, and true a Christian character, it's in the Lord Jesus Christ. If we want to know what real love is, it is in the Lord Jesus Christ. If we want to know what godly wisdom is, it is in the Lord Jesus Christ. So whatever question we may have, then by searching the scripture, we can find the answer through the Lord Jesus Christ. Why? Because in John 17:17, the Word of God is truth. It says, sanctify them through thy words. Thy word is truth. So there is no error in the Word of God. Once we make the Word of God as our final authority, then we are always end up in the truth. Truth about our life. Truth about our destination. Truth about the will of God. Truth about our family. Truth about our marriage, our children. Whatever it is, we can find the truth in the Word of God. And not only that, if we will make the Word of God a mighty part of our life, it will dispense blessing unto us. Look at Luke 11:28. Luke chapter 11:28. And when she had so said, she went her way and called Mary her sister secretly, the master come and call it for thee. So you can see that I was not able to write. I was able to write, but she was not able to flash the right verse. And that is something that must be corrected. But he said, yea, rather, blessed are they that hear the word of God and keep it. So it dispenses blessing. If you obey the word of God, there will be blessing. If you obey the word of God regarding how to be a good church member, there will be blessing. If you obey the word of God regarding how to be a church leader, there will be blessing. If you obey the word of God how to be a submissive wife, there will be blessing. If you obey the word of God on how to be a loving husband, there will be blessing. If you obey the word of God on how to be a good children, there will be blessing. So every time we obey the word of God, there will always be blessing. So that is very important. Because the word of God must be a necessary part of our lives. As was written in Matthew 4:4. Said unto them that man, it is written that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. So if we think that food is necessary for us to survive, then it is more necessary for us to consume the word of God, to be saturated with the word of God, so that we will live spiritually in a manner that is strong for the glory of God. So why all of these things are possible regarding the Word of God? Because in Psalms chapter 12 and verse number 6, this is what God testifies about His Word. The words of the Lord are pure words, as silver tried in a furnace of earth, purified seven times. The purification of God's Word is a perfect one. Therefore, the Word of God is perfect. Nobody can improve on the Word of God. That's why God says that you cannot add something to or remove anything from, because it is already perfect. It wants nothing more, because it is the Word of God. That is why our attitude should be 2 Timothy 2:15, that we are going to study to show ourselves approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Why? Because listen to me. Many times, we think that we know more than God. That is our problem. We think that we are better than God. Especially when it comes to child discipline. We have our own way of disciplining our children. We have our own principles. We have our own philosophy. And we think, because we thought about it, then we are right. Yan. Kaya dito sa child discipline na ito, maraming magulang kumokontra sa pamamalo sa anak. Kasi akala nila mas magaling sila sa Diyos. Yun ang nagiging problema. We think that I think that I will just wait for them to grow old. Because once that happened, they will understand what I'm saying, then they will obey. So you're saying that you know more than God. Because God is very, very clear. Train up a child in the way that he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. So that is the word of God versus your philosophy, versus your principles, versus what you are thinking. So if the word of God really has a purpose, if the word of God is given because it wants to accomplish something, if the word of God is alive and powerful and can really change lives, if the word of God can give us success, and if the word of God can provide the answer, and if the word of God is the truth, and there is blessing in obeying the word of God, and if the word of God is a necessary part of our life because it is perfect, that we need to study it, then we need to obey it. We need to make it as the final authority of our lives. Because no matter what happened, the word of God will endure forever. Look at 1 Peter 1:25. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse number 25. But the word of the Lord endureth forever, and this is the word which by the gospel is preached unto you. So the word of God will endure forever. We will pass away from the sin, but the word of God will continue to do his work in the lives of every children of God. So, what about child discipline? What can we see from the word of God that we must do? Listen, this is not a suggestion. This is the truth that is in the word of God that we must employ. You see, most of us have already neglected this. And I'm afraid for some it may be too late. I hope not. Because if it is already too late, then our children are already doomed. And they are going to live a problematic, chaotic, miserable life if we are too late. But I believe that if we are going to be diligent and firm in applying the word of God, then by the grace of God, we can still make it. So let us look at several things regarding this as an overview or introduction in our topic of child discipline. Number one, we must understand the nature of a child. We must understand the nature of a child. In Proverbs chapter 22 and verse number 15, this is what the Bible says, which is very, very clear. The Bible says, foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. So we need to understand that our children inherited a fallen, sinful nature when Adam and Eve fell, when they were in the Garden of Eden. So because of that, foolishness is already in the heart of a child. You do not have to teach a child how to be foolish. You must teach him how to be wise. But foolishness is already in the heart of every child because of the sinful nature. They are bent towards foolishness than wisdom. That is why in Proverbs 13:24, this is what I'm saying, that I hope we're not too late. Proverbs 13:24, he that spareth his rod hateth his son. No, Pastor, hindi ko pinapalo kasi nga mahal ko siya. Eh di sinungaling ang Diyos, tama ka. Because the Bible is very clear. He that spareth his rod hateth his son. So your love is actually hate in the eyes of God. Because you are not doing God's will in the lives of your children, and you are doing your own will in the lives of your children, thinking that your children belongs to you, that they do not belong to God. Parang ikaw ang creator nila, hindi ang Diyos. Kasi, sabi mo, hindi ko papaluin, naawa ako. Hindi tama yon. Ano sabi ng Diyos? He that spareth his rod, hateth his son. And I will believe God than you. And if you are not going to do this, you are hating your children. That's the truth. And the truth hurts. If we have a different understanding of the truth. Ano pa sabi niya? But he that loveth him, oh see, there is a contrast. Hating your children and loving your children. Not spanking them is hate. But he that loveth is I love at him, chasing at him betimes. See? If you love your children, you need to chastise them. When? Betimes. What do you mean by that? Betimes. Early. Hindi maraming beses. Early. As early as several months when character or attitude is already being developed in your children. Early. So I was asked a question before. When are we going to discipline our teenagers? While they were toddlers. You cannot discipline the teenagers anymore. It is now in the hands of God, not in your hands anymore. Because they already developed something that they will carry with them all their lives, except if God will save them and will renew or will give them a new heart. Tayo mga kapatid, let's go back sa ating buhay. Ang tanda na natin ngayon, pero yung mga naranasan natin ng bata tayo hanggang ngayon, nasa isip pa natin. Until now, some of those things are still being done by us. Why? Because it has been inculcated in us. That is the reason why the Bible is very clear that children must be disciplined early. Hindi umaga ha, hapon na, hindi ko na paluin to. Early in life. Hindi yung
Eh, hindi pa naman nila naiintindihan eh. Sinasabi sa'yo. Hindi naman ikaw yung bata eh.
Bakit ganito? Nung naalala ko, nung bata pa ako, ganito yung ano, nakita ko, kaya ginawa ko, na ano, kaya ginawa ko. Tapos, sabi mo, kita mo na kahit bata, alam na nila. Pero pag disiplina, wala pa silang alam, wag muna. Saan ba talaga? Saan ka ba talaga pupunta? Even if you will look at the lives of many people, they are blaming their early childhood for who they are today. Because those are the times that they are being developed, shaped, molded. So if we are not going to mold them with the model of the Lord, then they are going to be molded by the Word according to their model. So that is what will happen. Look at Proverbs 19:18. Look at what the Bible says. Chasten thy son while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare for his crying.
Eh, mga bata, artista na yan eh. Ito nga si JL eh.
Oh. Kunyari, aalis si ano? Si Milka. Kung alam mo, iyak, hindi naman. 1 year old enough pa lang yan. Kahit na nung bata-bata pa siya, nagagawa niya na yun. Nadidevelop na sila, nakakaintindi na sila. Kaya nga, chasten thy son while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare for his crying. This is the style of our children. If they know that they committed something wrong and you're about to spank them, they will cry. And then our hearts will be melted and we will not spank them anymore. And in the mind of these children, I just have to do this every time and I can get away with it. So that's why before the spanking session, they will always cry. Because they know that if they will do it, they can get away with it. Why? Because foolishness is bound in the heart of a child. And there is only one way that it can be driven away from them. What's it? The rod of correction. That's why the Bible is very clear. You spare not the rod from them. So, how are we, Pastor, going to use the rod? Puro paluan na lang ba? No. Hindi ito puro paluan. Pero, maraming paluan. Why? Because there is foolishness that must be driven away. It is already a given. That is why the Lord is very clear in Proverbs that there is something that we need to do to drive this foolishness away from them. Again, we have seen Proverbs 22:15. We read it a while ago. Proverbs 13:14, foolishness is bound, and then the rod of correction will drive it away from them. Look at Proverbs 29:15. The rod and reproof give wisdom. See? There is the rod and there is reproof. Hindi naman palo agad. Kakausapin mo. You will reprove them. But these are always in combination. The rod and reproof give wisdom. How are they going to become wise? Look at Timothy. He was wise unto salvation from a child. Why? Because he was given the rod and he was reproved. And he get wisdom, or he got wisdom from that. But a child left to himself bringeth his mother to shame.
Alalahanin na lang natin yung kantang anak. Isinilang siya, laking tuwa mo. Niyay mo siyang padapuan ng langaw. Overprotective ka. Niayo mong saktan. Sige, kung ano gusto niya, bigay. O ano, malaki na. Nais nang maging malaya. O, kahit di ka payag, wala kang magawa. O ano, bigla na lang silang nagbago. Bakit? Hindi naman sila nagbago. Yun talaga sila. Lumabas na lang. O, pinakita na yung tigas ng ulo. Oh, anong ginawa sa payo mo? Sinuway. Bandang uli, ano? Pahamak. Nabilanggo. Nakapatay. Nagnakaw. Napariwara. It brought shame to the mother. Bakit mother? Because most of the time, the mother is the one who's feeling it. Yung shame. Nadala ng kanilang anak. Mga lalaki kasi, medyo may tigas siya na kahit papano, nakakarga nila eh. Pero mga ina, hindi. And the rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself. See, left to himself. Don't do anything for the child. Just let him be. He's going to bring shame. Why? Because his tendency or her tendency is to continually be foolish in life. Sabi nga, naghigpit ka na nga, nalusot ang kape. Yung hindi ka pa kaya, naghigpit. Look at Proverbs 23:13-14. Withhold not the correction from the child, for if thou beatest him with a rod, he shall not die. Di mamamatay. Sino na ba na namatay sa pinalo at sa tamang paraan? Wala pa. Sa ulo, pinalo, mamatay. Oh, hindi, kita nyo ang dinisign ng Diyos. Kinapala ng puwit talaga. At wala ritong pwedeng magkaroon ng structural damage. Eh kahit ang balon si Mundus por dos simili, tatawa lang yan eh. Kinapalan talaga ang puwet. That's why the butt is thick, because this is a place where to spank children. And there can be no structural damage if you will spank them properly. But the Lord assures us that they will not die. Eh, Pastor, yung anak ko, makapal ang mukha eh. Yun ang mahirap. Kung ang mukha ang makapal. Sampal dito, sampal doon, ang dapat na aabutin yan. Thou shalt beat him with a rod. See? That's a command. Thou shalt beat him with a rod and shalt deliver his soul from hell. See, the rod of correction can help your child be saved. See? But if not, he or she will go to hell. Ah, hindi, Pastor, titiyakin kong tatanggap sa Panginoon yan. Hindi nga, yung disiplina nga, hindi mo natiyak eh. Yung kaligtasan pa. Oh. Don't you know that discipline is a precursor to our children understanding salvation in the proper time. Later on, we will see how it can help them be saved. But you see that the rod is mentioned 4 times in the book of Proverbs. Notice that it is the rod. It is not the fist. Okay? It is not the slap. It is not the pulling of the hair. It is not the kicking. It is not any other violent action. But the Bible is clear, it is the rod. Rod. Hindi kukuha ka ng tubo. Hahataw mo. No. It is the rod. That is the instruction of God, and that is very, very clear. It must be used instead of any man-made alternatives. Why? Because man, they think that they know more than God. They say that, I know, Lord, I know how to discipline my children away from your prescription. But ladies and gentlemen, if you will not obey the word of God sent for a purpose to bring prosperity and success, then your children will live a chaotic life, and when that happens and you're already dead, they are going to curse you. Because they will know that you did not do your part while they were young.
Mumurahin ka niya kung buhay ka pa pag napahamak sila. Oh, narinig ko na yan ako. Sabi ko sa inyo. Narinig ko na sa mga ibang magulang yan.
Dahil ko na na-counsel ng magulang na umiiyak, Pastor, ang anak ko, kung sagot-sagutin ako, ganun na lang. Bakit? Tataka ka pa. Oh. Ako lang, ang nanay ko, nung college ako, lagi niyang pinapagalitan. Nakatayo siyang ganun. Sinuntok ko eh. Hindi ko talaga pinatamaan. Ang pinatamaan ko yung gilid. Lusot yung kamao ko sa yung lawanit eh. Pagtingin niyang ganun, bigla siyang nalupasay, nag-iiyak eh. Oh. Eba, hindi niya ako dinisipline eh. Oh. Hindi niya ako tinuruan. So, nung napariwara ang buhay ko, ang sabi ko, eh, kayo kasi, wala pa ako isang taon, iniwan niyo ako. Anong klaseng magulang kayo? Ah, see? Meron na akong karapatan, kaya ko na eh. Ngayon, hindi magsasalita yung mga yan, hindi nila kaya. Pero when the time comes that they can stand with their own two feet and they can be stronger than you, then that's the time that you will see the result of your failure to discipline your children. That is why we need to follow the Lord when it comes to child discipline. Amen. So the rod must be used. It must be used when the child is rebellious. Why? Because it is a rod of correction. Look at Proverbs 22 again, verse 15. And then 23:13 again. Foolishness is bound in the heart of a child, but the rod of correction shall drive it far from him. And then 23:13, withhold not correction from the child, for if thou beatest him with a rod, he shall not die. So you need to understand that if they are showing a rebellious attitude, the rod of correction must be applied. Immediately, without hesitation, and with no way or room for negotiation. It must be applied immediately when they show a rebellious attitude. The rod must not be spared. Chapter 13, verse number 24. Very clear. He that spareth his rod hateth his son, but he that loveth him chasteneth him betimes. This is what I always ask my children. When I spank them, or before I spank them, and after I spank them, I said, why did I spank you? And their answer is, because you love us. And that is true. Because when I spank my children, I'm also hurting. But it is necessary. Because that is the word of God. And if I'm not going to do it, then they are going to go astray. You see, as I have told you, we are already very, very strict following child discipline from the word of God, and still sometimes the devil can still crawl in. And still inject his diabolical suggestion in the minds of our children. Because not every time we can really watch them. We are not there all the time. But at least if we lay a good foundation, there is a good chance that they're not going to depart from it. Even if they will stumble, even if they will fall, even if they will swerve from the left or the right, there is a very good chance that they will go back to the original path that God has given them. Why? Because it's already in their hearts. It's already inculcated in their mind. They know that there is a place or a person that they can run to when they come to their senses, if they will go astray. Then it must be used with sufficient force to correct the child. Do not overdo it. Imbawa, isang taon pa lang anak mo. Kaya sa ACE, hindi nyo, merong paraan ng pagpalo eh. Kung papaano ang posisyon, kung paano mong ipapalo na ganun yung rod of correction na yon, hindi yung gaganunin mo, hindi yung, kunyari, bata pa, hindi same ng force ng sa matanda. But see to it that it will get the message across. and that they will understand it. So that they will not do it anymore by the grace of God, or they will know that they are in for a very painful experience if they are going to do it again. So it must be applied with sufficient force. It must be used immediately once clear command is disobeyed. Like for example, you told your children, you do not answer back to the elders without respect. Once they did it, it must be applied at that very instance. Not in front of people, but bring them inside. And the rod of correction must be applied. Why? So that they will know that once they disobey a clear command or a clear rule, then there is going to be consequences that will follow. What's the consequences that will follow? Follow. Ayan. They need to understand that. Because if not, then they will keep on doing that. And they will push it as far as they can to see if you will give in or not. That is what our children are hoping for. Yung magsawa tayo. Dahil pag nagsawa tayo, wala na. And they can have their own way. Must be used wisely. That is why communication is very important. That they need to know why. Do not spank them without knowing why. Because it will develop confusion in their hearts and mind. And that will lead to rebellion. Because if you are going to hurt them without any reason, there is a tendency that they will also hurt other people without any reason. Because what they receive is most likely they are going to apply to other people. So make sure that the children understand the rules. Like for example, if the elders are talking, you do not interrupt them. Whatever is your need, unless it is absolute emergency, you do not interrupt them while they are talking. Or when you talk to a person older than you, you always say sir to a man and ma'am to a woman. Or because we're Filipinos, you always say po or opo. And if they will fail to do that, warn them, and again they will fail to do that, then there must be spanking. Why? What's the use of giving rules if you're going to apply the consequences? If they think that they can get away with it, then be sure they're going to do it again and again and again until such time that you will step in and discipline them. When discipline is necessary, take the child aside privately and tell him that what he has done wrong and how he will be disciplined. Okay, what wrong did you do? I lied. What will be the consequence? Spanking. Why? Because it is wrong to lie. And I should not do it. So you will be spanked. Yes. They must learn how to accept punishment. Because it will develop their character. It will instill to them responsibility and accountability. That they need to own to the consequences of their actions. So if they will not accept it, then you do it again. And if they will not accept it, you do it harder until such time that they learn to accept it. May mga anak ko, papaluin kayo, diba? Sabi niyo, naiinis kayo. Iyak ka! Tapos lalakasan ko pa. Iyak ka! Gusto kong hindi sila umiyak talaga. Yung umiyak sila, lumuha sila, yes. Pero ayoko yung iyak na parang may iyak na nagre-rebelde. Iyak na nagre-reklamo. Ayoko ng iyak na ganun. Kailangan yung iyak na dahil tinanggap nila yung parusa nila. Yung may acceptance doon sa kanilang consequence. So make sure that it will happen. And then carry out the discipline with self-control, explaining first to the child what will happen. So this is how we're going to do that. Usually when I spank them, after I spank them, we pray. But I have to admit there are times that I spank them because I'm angry. And that should not be. That's wrong on my part. But as much as possible, it should be exercised with self-control, making them understand it, making them accept the punishment, and then empathizing with them. Making them understand that I know you are hurt, but I'm also hurting because I am your father or I'm your mother and I love you very much. But I am not going to let the devil ruin your life. So we are going to apply the word of God and discipline you accordingly. Hug the child and tell him that you love him, even after you spanked them. Explain why the discipline had to happen and why their actions were wrong. Talk with them about how they can correct their action so that they will not do it again in the future. And always emphasize that obedience is required by God. And that is not just our own program. This is not just what I want. This is what God wants. So that they will understand that you are doing it simply because you are obeying God and God's will for their lives. Why? Because the objective of discipline is this: to teach them obedience and respect for authority. Why do we have to do that? Because our children do not know God yet, especially when they were young. We are the image of God in the family. And once we taught them how to respect authority as our authority as parents and to obey to us, then when we introduce them to God, it will be very easy for them to obey because they will understand that God is the highest authority. And that will make them wise unto salvation. So because we are the first authority in their lives, not God. Because they do not know God yet, and they will not understand God yet. But if we will serve as a good example of an authority in their lives, then once God is introduced, then they will easily understand how to respect and obey God in their lives. Listen to this. When children become accustomed to disobeying their parents and getting away with it, they are likely to adopt the same attitude toward God's will. Authority ka eh, na-disobey ka eh. So authority ang God, di disobey ko rin. Because I disobey this authority, I can disobey this authority. But if I learn to respect this authority, I definitely will respect this authority because I will see that even the authority that I respected is under the authority of the God that they are introducing to me. Ako niya bigay sabihin, that's why don't let them get away with an attitude of disobeying authority. That's why you see, our children must be taught to, like for example, if our children are around and they will see elder people, they will know how, they must know how to show respect to elder people. Like, for example, I am young and I see Brother Rilson. I say, good evening, Sir Rilson. Good evening, Sir Jed. Good evening, Ma'am Lua. It should be like that. Not that they will see people and they will just ignore them. We're showing that we're not teaching our children. But my children is shy. That's why we're training them. Not to be shy because what we're teaching them is not wrong. Sabi mo, kasi mahihiyain ang anak ko eh. Eh pagkatapos, ang anak mo nakapagsasalita ng hindi maganda sa matanda. Like for example, you see, our children are speaking in English. I want them to speak in English, but I do not want them to adopt the attitude
of Western children that they can even tell their parents, I hate you. If my children will tell me that they hate me when they were young, during their younger years, they are going to taste something that they haven't tasted before in their lives. Why will you hate me? I'm teaching you what is right. I'm doing what is right. And you will tell me you hate me? Or you will be in for the spanking of your life. This is what I'm always telling our children. Don't you ever answer back to your mother. Don't you ever shout to your mother. Actually, I was wrong in some instance. Sinagot ni Jong ang mama niya, nagmumugsa ng dugo. Which is wrong. But I do not want him to develop an attitude of answering back to her mother. Because they will not answer back to me. Not a chance. But they may do it to my wife. And she is an authority to them. And they should not do that. And I do not encourage my children to say something wrong to other people. Oh, you know, ayokong teacher si brother, Haji sa Sunday school, masyadong boring. No. Children have no right to say that. But pastor, yung pag-express nila ng sarili nila, pinipigilan natin, hindi natin pinipigilan natin mag-express sila ng kabastusan. Pero mag-express sila ng tama, i-encourage natin. Pero sabihin, I don't like her. She's not brushing her teeth. Telling that to older people, my. What kind of attitude or character is that? What? They're just young. So what will they say when they're older? You understand what I'm saying? So once they get away with this, they will keep on doing it. And they will keep on saying it. Of course, they will commit mistake. That is why we correct them. But we should not let them get away with any of it. Parents must use every opportunity to teach their children obedience, and the training and discipline must be consistent. If not consistent, we will confuse our children and our discipline will never be effective. Bakit nung dinisobey ko, pinalo ako ngayon? Hindi naman. Diba? So ano ba talaga siya? Ano ba talaga yung totoo sa sinasabi niya? Sabi niya, pag ginawa ko yun, papaluin niya ako. Hindi niya ako pinalo. Sinungaling itong magulang ko. Ah, see? My father and mother is a liar. Because they told me that if I will do this, they will spank me. I did it. They did not spank me. So they're lying. So if they lied here, they might be lying in other things also. You see? We are giving a wrong signal. That's why our discipline must be consistent and cooperative. If the rule of the husband, the father, must also be the rule of the mother. It's not like when the father disciplines the children and then the mother will come to the rescue. Come here, your father really is evil. So you are destroying the character of your children. This is our agreement with Sister Maribel. Sometimes I may be wrong, but even if I am wrong, Sister Maribel will show our children that she is on my side. So there is nobody they can run to but to accept their discipline. So if we will discuss about it, we discuss in a private room, not allowing our children to hear it. So you have to be careful in this because children are very impressionable. And they mimic things. So if we will mess up in front of our children, then there is a good chance that they're going to do it. So children must be taught to be respectful of authority figures other than parents. Oh, nirespeto naman ako ng anak ko eh. Oh, yung Sunday school teacher niya, nirespeto niya.
Yung pastor ng simbahan niyo, nirerespeto niya? Yung matatanda na member ng church, nirerespeto nila? Hindi lang sa parents ang respect. Sa lahat ng figures of authority. Maging sa gobyerno, pati namumuno, mga teachers nila, they must know how to respect them. Because if they will learn to respect people of authority, then it will develop as a good character in them. They will grow up a respectful person. Hindi ka mapapahiya. Kasi minsan, ang problema natin, masyado tayong informal eh. Kamukha nung may sasabihin ng anak natin na hindi maganda sa isang matanda, natatawa pa tayo. Sabi niya, uy, bakit ang laki ng ilong mo? Parang kita ko na yung utak mo. Hindi, tatawa tayo. Kala nung bata, okay. Ba, nakakatawa pala yun. Gagawin ko nga ulit. Uy, ang liit ng utak mo, lalabas sa ilong. Tapos tatawa ka na naman. Akala ng bata, acceptable. Di ba, minsan, madali natin kayo, napagkukwentuhan pa natin. Minsan, sa harapan ng bata, napapagkwentuhan natin. Kaya para sa kanya, okay lang. Akala niya, ayos lang. Narinig natin na may sinabi siyang hindi maganda sa matanda, hindi man natin kinorek. So, akala niya, okay lang. And then, most of the time, we're not even concerned about what they're watching, what they're doing. Ay, hindi, nag-game lang sila, Pastor. Hindi nyo ba alam ngayon sa mga game, lalo na yung mga live games, merong ano ron, chatting doon. At doon kumukuha ng mga bata, mga pedophile. Kaya ingatan natin. Hindi, magtataka ka na lang, ba't nagmumura anak ko? Hindi ko naman tinuruan na magmura. Eh, hindi nga, yung mga nababasa, napapanood. Kaya minomonitor sila. Kaya as much as possible, we should limit their use of gadgets, or as much as possible, don't let them use those gadgets until they are responsible. Ganun dapat. Ako lumaki ko, mga kapatid, wala akong iPad, walang lahat. Ang gamit namin nun yung lata, tapos merong string. Hello? Punta ako dyan. Yun ang gamit namin. Nung bata kami. Huwag niyong pagamitin. Kasi, para wag pastor magulo, para wag maingay, hayaan ko na lang. Ayun nga, hinayaan mo. Ano nakalagay dito? Left to himself will bring shame to his mother. Pinabayaan mo eh. Ginawa mong yaya yung ano? Yung iPad, yung iPhone, yung television, etc., etc. Hindi nyo papasimisin yung mga bata kung magsalita, cartoons. Di ba? Bakit? Eh, yun ang napapanood nila eh. Ay, yung kakaming na. Kanyang ganun eh. Naraw, ay, yung kakaming na. Eh, napapanood nila. So, we have to be careful. So, that is why. Children, again, need to be taught to do things that exhibit respect for authority. Kung tapusin natin to, the Bible places so much emphasis in obeying authority. Look at Romans 13:1. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Ephesians 5:21-22. Submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. Amen? Gusto niyo na mag-basketball? Ephesians 6:1-3. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. See? Is it wrong to obey your parents? Francis, is it wrong to obey your parents? Or is it right? Right. Chut. Is it right to obey your parents or no? Right to obey. That's what God says. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise. So you need to honor your parents. Baka naman dala niya, magdala kayo ng medal. Hindi yung first honor. Honor, respect. Yung mga bata, ganun kapiloso po minsan eh. Ito po, honor. Ligaman. That it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. You see, if you honor your parents, you will live longer than those who dishonor their parents. That is the promise of God. So that's why a lot of people are dying young because they're disobedient to parents. 1 Thessalonians 5, 12 to 13. And we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake, and be at peace among yourselves. So authority in the church, in the school, authority to those people that are taking care of you. 1 Timothy 5, 1 and 2. Rebuke not an elder, but entreat him as a father, and the younger men as brethren, the elder women as mothers, the younger as sisters with all purity. So, the elders may sometimes be wrong. Can I tell them if they are wrong? Yes, but in a respectful way. Hindi yung kahirap talaga magpalaki ng magulang. Eh kung di ka ba naman isa't kalahating bobo, hindi nalalaki ang magulang, matanda na. Kahit anong gawin mo, hindi mo mapapalaki yan. Pero, pag nirespeto mo, mabuting asa lang maidudulot sa'yo. So you respect them. 1 Timothy 5:17. Let the elders that rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially they who labor in the word and doctrine. Provide for them. O, kayong mga anak, nung mga bata kayo, your parents provided for you. Maybe now they are old and you are receiving more than them. So why don't you provide for them? Oh, do something in order to honor what they have done for you. I'm not saying that they're expecting you to return the favor, but it will be doubly sweet if you will do it willingly to them and for them. Titus 3:1. Put them in mind to be subject to principalities and powers, to obey magistrates, to be ready to every good works, etc., etc. Marami pang mga verses. Isa na lang, 1 Peter 2:17. Honor all men, love the brotherhood, fear God, honor the king. You see, the Bible is very clear and fully emphasizes respect to authority. Now, if we want our children to grow up in the way of the Lord, then they must be taught to respect authority. That they should not do anything in front of authorities or even without the authorities, because God is the absolute authority and God knows what they're doing and God is seeing that. So I hope that we can all agree with this and hold each other responsible for the discipline of our children. Because, you see, as a parent, because I already have grown children, two of them are already married. As a parent, the most painful thing that you will experience is when your children turn on you. Wala nang sasakit pa ron. Yung pagkatapos lumaki, kinaya na, tinalikuran ka na.
Kilala, meron siyang ako. Binuhos niya lahat dun sa ato niya. Talagang minahal niya. Pinaaral niya, ginapang niya talaga para magkaroon ng magandang kinabukasan. Ba't mo may edad ng konti, may nagawa siya hindi nagustuhan. Gumawak ng kutsino at sabi, Mami ang tawag sa kanya. Mami, pagpakali ka. Talagang yung pakiramdam niya, hindi niya maintindihan kung ano. Pero inunawa niya pa rin. Dahil mahal na mahal niya. So nagtatundo ulit sila. Pundasyon at meron tamang takot sa Diyos. Kasi mapariwara man yan. Pag na-realize niya ng pagkakamali niya, alam niya kung paano babalik. Doon sa daan, nagginapayan niya siya. Kesa sa hindi. Tandaan mo, foolishness is bound in the heart of a child. But the rod of correction will drive it away from him. So I hope that we will do that
and we will help each other in disciplining our children. If you will see some of these children doing foolishness, you talk to their parents in the right way. Tell them what's happening. Tell them what you see so that they can act accordingly. Pag naman sinumbong sa inyo, anak nyo, huwag kayong magagalit. Analyze nyo. Tignan nyo kung tama, kung totoo yung pagsumbong. And then tignan nyo kung paano nyo matutulungan ang inyong mga anak. Sabi ko nga, I hope it's not yet too late. But if we will cooperate and help each other, I believe we can still turn these things around. And we are going to have children growing up in the way of the Lord. And this church will be in good hands. By the grace of God. Because the next generation will grow up knowing what is right, knowing how to do what is right, and most especially, knowing how to obey God and those people in authority. So I hope and I pray that we will start teaching them. We can always start. Listen. We can always start. So, as I end, eto, dagdag na lang ito. During our Sunday school, that's 1 hour. And then after that, we have a break from 15 to 30 minutes. Please do everything that is necessary for you to do at that time. And during our worship service, as much as possible, I would like to really ask you, as much as possible, do not stand up and go out. Especially our children, they will stay here until the end of the service. Sunday school teacher, you sit beside them and you control them during the service time. Do not let them write anything. I know that some of you are writing the message, but don't do it. You listen first. There will be times to write it anyway. You can watch on YouTube, and that's the time that you can write the outline. But I want you not to be doing anything but to be listening to the preacher. every service time, do not stand up, do not go to your parents and then back to your seat. When you sit there during the start of the service, you stay there until the end of the service. Except on emergency situations. Amen? All of us, including me, if I can stay, I must stay if I'm not preaching. Except if you are sick. And let us know if you are sick. So that if you will stand up, at least we know that you have a condition. And we can understand that. But if not, then please don't. Because that is one way of showing our children how important the preaching of the Word of God is. And if they can see that we cannot listen or we're not listening, so we are sending a wrong signal. And as much as possible, those of you that are using your cell phones or iPad for Bibles, please be sure that you are using the Bible app only. Because some of you are using Facebook during preaching time. No, Pastor, because what I've heard is really a blessing, I really have to share it. No, after the service, share it. Not during the service. Please, let us, for the sake of our children, let's do it. It, you know, by disciplining them, it will also help us discipline ourselves. Because we need to see to it that we are going to be a model for them that they will follow. So I hope we are clear in that. Because I already have my chair here. So even if I'm not preaching, I will be sitting here. And everyone who is standing up and going out, look at me. That's how I react. One time you go out, look at me. And you will see my reaction. Because sometimes I do not just want to go out. Pastor, I'm sleepy. You buy a needle, put it here. If you feel sleepy, put some puncture on your legs or side. I guarantee you, you won't fall asleep. And if you really cannot fight it, try to poke your eyes with a needle. You won't be able to sleep for many days. I guarantee you that. So let us again exercise that discipline. Because we are becoming so relaxed. We're not minding the important things that we must show our younger people here at church. Even our attitude when we're in public, we have to really be careful. Because if they will see that we are without any restraint, then there's a possibility that they will copy that and show the same way. So I hope and I pray that we will continue to give lessons regarding church child discipline every Wednesday. But I'm going to say to you that it's just about 20 to 30 minutes at the most. The only way that I spend more time to this is because tomorrow is holiday. So if every Thursday is holiday, we're going to have extra time in our studies. Shall we stand up and let's pray? Father, we thank you for the lesson that you have given us regarding how to discipline our